Remember the purposes of cutout devices in clandestine operations. They can hide the existence of a contact, they can protect the higher echelon against detection, and they can impede the investigation by the active opposition. They can serve as a means of effecting communications. For example, the man in this bail bond office is a cutout, and he is impeding investigation.
Hello.
Good morning.
Hello, Dave.
Come on in, Lieutenant. What can I do for you?
This is Inspector Briggs of the FBI.
Yes, sir. Sit down.
You arranged bail for one Robert Danker.
That's right.
Do you mind telling us who put up the money?
No, not at all. Let's see. Danker, here we are, Robert Danker. Suspicion of robbery, bond $5,000, cash by John Smith.
Yeah, Mr. Smith again. Do you know this Mr. Smith?
Never met him before in all my life. Wouldn't know him if I saw him again.
Any address?
Yeah, but I think you'll find it's a phony like the name. They all do it. Hotel Conlon.
Never heard of it. Uh-huh. Thanks, anyway.
Anytime.
In these next examples, the cutout's primary task is to serve as a means of communication.
Three murders. We'll have the gang we're after. Gene, you're going to follow in Danker's steps. Si, as I explained, you're to surveil him every minute. Gene's only communication, unless otherwise directed, is going to be through you.
I understand.
Si will be living right across the street at the Gilbert. This Danker was a tough kid that knew his way around. You ought to be his carbon copy.
Right, sir.
Now, this is our plan. Suppose you were to drift into Center City.
Here, the cutout meets his principal in a penny arcade. This time, the cutout meets his principal in a greasy spoon.
Well, it is.
Coffee and?
Out of donut.
Okay, give me some pie.
Out of pie. Toast.
You won't get an argument out of me, honey. Toast. Hamburger.
With?
Everything.
Say, miss, when's the next ferry?
Every hour and a half hour.
And in this one, the principal is preparing his message in a match folder, using it as a concealment device, which the cutout will recover. Thank you. And here, we will see the cutout transmitting his information right to the higher echelon.
Received urgent message from Gene.
Remember the various kinds of cutouts? The dead drop, stationary or moving. The live drop, in place or mobile, sometimes referred to as the intermediary or the courier, witting or unwitting. The safe house, and the accommodation address. Let's examine some of these in detail. First, the dead drop. A museum offers good possibilities for dead drop sites. And although a church is not a good place to meet and talk, it offers numerous opportunities for drop locations. Places of worship in other areas of the world and for other religions have similar potential. Every phase of human activity warrants consideration. Even a time clock card rack may meet your requirements. In this sequence, we see the familiar sight of the locker section of a station. These lockers offer convenient drop sites for clandestine purposes and may be used as transfer points for articles ranging from small messages to fairly bulky items. There are, however, some serious disadvantages to the locker as a dead drop site. The drop is under the control of the locker or station management personnel, and bus, air, or railroad stations are usually heavily policed. Now let's consider the moving dead drop. Here again, there are numerous possibilities. This train, for example, a message may have been concealed in a journal box, a porter's closet, or elsewhere, making the train a moving dead drop. It offers numerous advantages. Its schedule is known, it runs regularly, and its route unchanging. Plane may offer similar advantages. Even this peasant's cart may provide hiding places. This ship might be suitable. Or possibly one of the native boats. The innocuous bicycle offers possibilities also. The live drop may be witting or unwitting, in place or mobile. The proprietor of this newsstand might be used as a live drop in place, either in a witting or an unwitting capacity. Let's move now to Lisbon. Here, a courier approaches this Portuguese watchmaker, a witting live drop, in order to make a pickup. The courier's own watch serves as a signal, a concealment device, and as cover for the stop. Observe that the watchmaker will return a different watch in which microfilm is concealed. Neither party is aware of the nature of the microfilm message. This young lady is a courier. She's being taken to the cleaners. The proprietor of this laundry, however, has no ulterior motive. He is a witting live drop in place and is a part of the clandestine communication system. laundry? Not exactly. For this handkerchief bears a very special message in secret writing. Notice where the live drop places it. Notice also that the live drop controls the message while it is in his possession. Enter the party of the second part. This cutout has served as a means of communication and also has apparently concealed the existence of contact between the girl and this man. We have been watching the live drop in place. In this sequence, observe the witting mobile live drop in action. The mobile live drop might also be referred to as the intermediary or sometimes as a courier. The exchange of newspapers, and incidentally of messages, is now completed. Another useful type of cutout is the accommodation address. The accommodation address, as the name implies, is a cutout or transfer point for items which have been sent by public communications facilities, such as the mails, telegraph, cable, and the like. Establishing a good accommodation address presents many difficulties, including a good cover story, concealing the contents of the message or package, not to mention avoiding censorship. Once again, all forms of human activity should be considered and imagination utilized in selecting and setting up an accommodation address. This theater might serve the purpose, if the cover of the principals makes it possible for them to correspond through such an installation. Even this funeral parlor could be used as an accommodation address or as a live drop, and if you'll pardon the pun, even a dead drop site. Here, our principal is using a barber shop, but let's follow him to a taxidermist shop that he is using as an accommodation address.
Afternoon.
Won't you sit down?
I take Pongo. That's Pongo. I give them all names because there's so many.
Yes, yes, come. A gentleman has asked me to call for the red fox.
The fox male or female?
The fox is female.
Will it remain with your friends on this voyage?
Yes, that is the idea.
I'm told there is a good market in Mexico City.
Mexico City?
Mm-hmm.
Right. I will tell my friend what you say. Now then, when may I call for the fox?
My daughter will bring it to you tonight.
Clara!
Clara is my daughter's
name.
Hello.
Yes, we've met before.
She will meet you down at the old steps near the Surtees house.
Good. 11 o'clock?
She will be punctual. The price of the animal will be 150 pounds.
Yeah, yeah. Ridiculous.
Inclusive.
You look very tired, my friend. You should take a holiday.
Me? Holidays cost money.
But would £100 give you a pleasant weekend at the seaside?
Where?
Perhaps 125?
I'll give it to your daughter.
Now that we have examined several kinds of cutout devices in some detail, let's observe some of them in operation. This is a safe house.
Mm-hmm.
The principal has given the safe house keeper an item for the courier. Notice how the safe house keeper compartments the principal from the courier. Here we see a technician preparing a microfilm message for forwarding to a higher echelon. Places the microfilm on this envelope. As the action develops, observe the sequence, number, and kind of cutouts involved. The flower shop is an accommodation address. The messenger boy is an unwitting courier. Here we have the resident chief. The dead drop.
Thank you.
finally, the woman courier. These are some of the cutout devices in action. The intermediary or mobile live drop, the dead drop, stationary or moving, the safe house keeper, the unwitting courier, the accommodation address, all serving to hide the existence of contact, protect the higher echelon, impede investigation by the opposition, and to serve as a means of effecting communication.